everyone, welcome back to my channel at Dipak Class 10. In this video lecture, we will learn the next chapter of Class 10, Civics Federalism. So, what is federalism? To understand the term federalism, let us go back to the last chapter that we studied, power sharing arrangement. In Belgium, the key changes were made in the constitution, and in 1993 gave the regional government constitutional powers. And in Sri Lanka, a unitary system where the national government has all the powers. Now, what is federalism? Federalism is a system of government in which the power is divided between a central authority and various constituent units of the country. Then a federation has two levels of the government, central government and state or provincial government. Central government is for the entire country, usually responsible for few subjects of common national interest. And then state government that looks after much of the day-to-day administration of their state. These both levels enjoy their power independent of each other. Now, federal state of government. Federal states, two more levels of government, and unitary system of government, only one level. In federal system, state government has its own power for which it is not answerable to the central government, and unitary government, national level government has all the powers. In federal system, the central government cannot order the state government to do something, and in unitary system, central government can pass orders on the local government. In federal system, governments at any level are answerable to the people. Now, features of federalism. There are two or more levels. For example, state and local self-governments. Second is jurisdiction. Different tiers of government govern the same citizen, but each tier has their own jurisdiction. It means that the area over which somebody has legal authority. And in third feature, the jurisdiction of each level are specified in the constitution. Thus, existence and authority of each tier is constitutionally guaranteed. Fourth, the fundamental provision of the constitution cannot be unilaterally changed. Fifth, courts have the power to interpret the constitution. Sixth, financial autonomy is not ensured. Sixth, dual objective, to safeguard and promote the unity of the country and to accommodate regional authority. Then, a federal system have mutual interest and agreement to live together. In mutual trust, government at different levels should agree some rules of power sharing and agreement to live together. They should also trust each other, would abide by its part of the government. Types of federation. Coming together federation and holding together federation. The exact balance of power between the central and the state government varies from one federation to the other. Coming together federation, independent states coming together on their own, and all the constituent states usually have equal power, and the main aim of the federation is to pool their sovereignty and maintain their separate identity. Example are US and Australia. Holding together, large country decide to divide its power between constituent states and the national government. The central government tends to be more powerful vice versa the states. And in this type of federation, there is absence of pooling sovereignty and maintaining identity. Example, India and Belgium. Now, what makes India a country federal? India has emerged as an independent nation after a painful bloody partition. Several princely states become a part of the country. Constituent declared India as the union of states. And word federation not used, but the Indian union is based on the principles of federalism. Now, what do you understand by vertical division of power? When power is shared among government different levels, that is the union or the central government, the state government and the municipality and the panchayat at the lower level, this division of power involving higher and lower level is called as vertical division. सबसे पहले हमारी सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट जो मोदी जी चलाते हैं, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट यूपी में जो योगी जी चला रहे हैं, म्यूनिसिपैलिटी और ग्राम पंचायत, ये म्यूनिसिपैलिटी और ग्राम पंचायत एमएलए और उधर के जो लोग चलाते हैं. ग्राम सभा का लीडर कौन होता है? पंचायत. इफ़ वी कंसिडर द फीचर ऑफ फेडरलिज्म स्टडीड अबव, Then all of them applies to a country. Initially there are two tiers, and third tier is added, that is panchayat and municipalities, and different tier enjoy separate and special jurisdiction. And the constitution also clarify down threefold distribution of legislature. Now three lists: union list, state list, and concurrent list. State list, subjects of the national importance like defense of the country, foreign affairs, etc. And why only these subjects have the power to take the national decisions? Because we need a uniform policy on these matters throughout the country. Now, and who can make these laws? The union government alone can make law. State list, subjects of state and local importance like police, trade, commerce, agriculture, etc. Jurisdiction, it differs from state to state. Who can make these laws? State government. Concurrent list, subject of common interest, education, forest, trade, union, etc. What happens if there is conflict between two? Law made by government, union government or central government will prevail. Who can make the law on both subjects, both union as well as state government? Then what is residuary subject? Subjects, the subjects not covered in those three lists fall under this list. Example, computer software, e-commerce, etc. And who can make the law? The union government only. Union list has total of 97 subjects. State law, state list has 66. Concurrent list has a total of 47. Not all states in India have identical powers. States such as Assam, Nagaland, Arunachal Pradesh, and Mizoram enjoy special powers under certain provisions of the Constitution, India, Article 371. These special powers are especially enjoyed in relation to the protection of land, rights to indigenous people, their culture, and also preferential employment in government. There are some units of the Indian Union which enjoy very little power. Example, Chandigarh or Lakshadweep, capital of Delhi, are called Union Territories. These are too small to become an independent state, but which could not be merged with any of the existing states are called as Union Territories. These territories do not have the powers of the state. The central government has special powers in running these areas. How to make changes to this power sharing arrangement? Sharing of power between the union and the state government is basic to the structure of constitution. There are two steps to make change. Any change to it has to be first passed by both the House of Parliament with at least 2/3 majority. Second, then it has to be ratified by the legislature of at least half of the total seats. Rule of judiciary, overseeing the implementation of constitutional, provincial and procedure. Dispute about division of power settled by High Court and Supreme Court. Then third, the High Court stands at the head of the state judicial administration. Where does the government get the money to do welfare of the state? The union and the state government have the power to raise resources by levying taxes. How is federalism practiced? The success of federalism. Constitution provision are necessary for the success of federalism, but these are not sufficient. The real success of federalism in India, nature of democratic politics in our country, this ensures the spirit of federalism, respect for diversity, desires for living together become shared ideals in our country. Linguistic states. Creating of linguistic states was the first major test of democratic politics. Since 1947, 2020, number of old states vanished and new states were created. This was done to ensure that people will spoke the same language lived in the same state. Some states were created on the basis of culture, ethnicity, and geography. These include states like Nagaland, Uttarakhand, and Jharkhand. When the demands for the formation of states on the basis of language was raised, some national leaders feared that it would lead to the disintegration of the country. It has also made administration easier. The central government resisted linguistic states for some time, but the experience has shown that formation of linguistic states has actually made the country more united. It has also made administration easier. India before partition and India after partition. Sorry. India before partition and India after partition, you can see in these two maps. Then India's Kapura Naksha, which you all learn in your lower classes. Then linguistic policies. A second test for Indian Federation is a language policy. Our constitution do not give the status of national language to any language. Hindi was identified as the official language, but Hindi is the mother tongue of only about 40% Indians. Therefore, there were many safeguards to protect other languages. Thus, we have two official languages, Hindi and English. Besides Hindi, Indian Constitution recognized 21 languages as scheduled language in total 22. Of these, Hindi was considered the official language of the country. A candidate in an examination conducted for the central government position may opt to take the examination in any of the languages recognized by the Constitution. States to have their own special languages. Case of 1965, according to the Constitution, the use of English for official purpose was stopped in 1965. Many non-Hindi speaking states demanded that the use of English continue. In Tamil Nadu, these movement take a violent form. Result, the central government agreed to continue the use of English along with the Hindi. Many critics think that the solution favored the English-speaking elite. Promoting of Hindi continues to be the official policy of the government of India. Promotion does not mean the central government can impose Hindi on states where people speak a different language. The flexibility shown by the Indian political leaders helped the country avoid the kind of situation that Sri Lanka finds itself in. Most spoken languages in each state of India. You can see Scheduled Languages of India. Assamese is spoken 1.26, Bengali 8.3, Bodo 0.12, Dogri 0.21, Gujarati 4.58, Hindi 43.63, Kannada 3.61, Kashmiri 0.56, Konkani 0.19, Mithali 1.12, Malayalam 2.88, Manipuri 0.15, Marathi 6.86, Nepali 0.24, Odia 3.10, Punjabi 2.74, Sanskrit no one, and Santali 0.61, Sindhi 0.23, then Tamil 5.70, Telugu 6.70, Urdu 4.19. Central state relation. Restructuring the central state relation can strengthen federalism in practice. For a long time, when party ruled both center and in most state, this meant that state government did not exercise their right as autonomous federal units. The central tried to undermine the power of the state, which was ruled by different party. In those days, the central government would often misuse the constitution to dismiss the state government that were controlled by rival parties. This undermined the spirit of federalism. Beginning the era of coalition government, after 1990, the rise of regional political parties in many states of the country, era of coalition government began at the center. Second, since no single party got a clear majority in Lok Sabha, major national parties had to enter into alliance with many parties, including several regional parties, to form a government of the center. Third, this led to a new culture of power sharing and respect for the autonomy of state government. Fourth, this was even supported by Supreme Court that made difficulties for the central government to dismiss state government in arbitrary matter. What now difference in alliance and coalition? Alliance. When two or more parties join hands for purpose of contesting elections is known as alliance. Alliance. Coalition, when no party wins the majority, then two or more parties join hands to form government. For example, BJP Left Front. Now, decentralization in India. A vast nation as India cannot run only through two tiers. This is states in India are highly populated and are internally very diverse. This is a need for power sharing within these states. This is the rationale for decentralization of power. This resulted a third tier of government called local government. When power is taken away from central and state government and given to the local, it is called as decentralization. Union government or central government, फिर आती हमारी state government, फिर local government, और शहरों में आता है local government में municipal corporation, municipal council और नगर पंचायत, और गांवों में आता है district पंचायत, intermediate पंचायत और village पंचायत. फिर द बेसिक आइडिया बिहाइंड डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन वॉज कि लार्ज नंबर ऑफ इशूज एंड प्रॉब्लम्स आर बेस्ट सॉल्व एट द लोकल लेवल. पीपल हैव बेटर नॉलेज ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स इन देयर लोकेलिटीज. दे ऑल्सो हैव बेटर आइडियाज ऑन वेयर टू स्पेंड मनी एंड हाउ टू मैनेज थिंग्स मोर एफिशिएंटली. At the local level, there is direct partition of people in decision making, which helps to include a habit of democratic partition. Local government is the best way to realize local self-government. Condition before 1922, several attempts were made to decentralize power to the levels of village and towns. Panchayats in village and municipalities in urban areas were set up in all the states, but were directly under the control of state government. Elections through these local government were not held regularly. Local government did not have any power or resources at their own. Thus, there were very little decentralization in effective term. A major step toward decentralization was taken in 1992. The constitution was amended to make the third tier of democracy more powerful and effective. Now, it is constitutionally mandatory to hold regular elections to the local government bodies. Seats are reserved in the elected bodies, and executive heads of these institutions for scheduled castes, scheduled tribes, and other backward classes. At least 1/3 of all the population are reserved for women. An independent institution called the State Election Commission has been created in each state to conduct panchayat and municipal elections. The state government is required to share some powers and revenue with local government bodies. Now, governance structure. First, Modi ji ki sarkar central government, Yogi ji ki sarkar state government, Zila Parishad now and district, Zila Pratishad, first come blocks, municipal corporation, municipalities, town councils, blocks, then in villages, village assembly, Gram Panchayats, Gram Sabha, Panchayat Samitis, Mahanagar Palikas, Nagar Palika and Nagar Panchayat. Rural government of Panchayati Raj. Gram Panchayat, each village or a group of village in some state has a Gram Panchayat. Decision making body is a council consisting of several ward members, often called Panch, and a president or sarpanch. Members are directly elected by an adult population living in the ward or the village. Gram Sabha work for overall supervision of a panchayat. Members, all the voters of the village, meet at least twice or thrice a year to approve the annual budget of the Gram Panchayat. Reviews the performance of the Gram Panchayat. Gram Sabha, permanent body, all adult voters and two meetings held each other. Gram Panchayat, temporary body, executive body, meeting held by sarpanch every month. Now comes Panchayat Samiti and Zila Parishad. A few panchayats are grouped together to form Panchayat Samiti or block or mandal. The members of this representative body are elected by all the panchayat members in that area. All the Panchayat Samitis or mandal in a district together constitute the Zila Parishad. Most members of the Zila Parishad are elected. Members are MPs, MLAs and other official local government bodies in urban areas. Municipalities are set up in towns. Municipal corporation constitute in big cities. Municipal chairperson is the political head of the municipality. Municipal corporation is called as mayor. Conclusion. Now, merits of decentralization. Local government is the largest experiment of democracy. There are now about 36 lakh elected representatives in the panchayat and municipalities. Constitutional status of local government has helped deepen the country. Women's representation and voice has increased. Demerits of decentralization. While elections are held regularly and enthusiastically, Gram Sabha elections are not regularly held. Most state government have not transferred significant figures to the local government. Lack of adequate sources, and hence there is a long way to achieve the ideal of self. In chapter cartoons, the state plead for more powers, perils of running a coalition government, NCERT questions. Please do it by yourself, okay? So, thank you for watching my video. Please like and share my video, and please do not